Hello, wonderful people. It's Lord Magicus here. And once again, we are joined by Yarok, and we are playing more of our Final Fantasy V 4-Job Fiesta playthrough.
Hello, everyone.
Yep. Everything looks like we should be good here. So, yeah, remember, 4-Job Fiesta is free for anybody to play. It's really fun. I think it's the best way to experience this game, and they also try to do this to get attention for charity. So if you have a few extra dollars you would like to donate to their charity, it is for the Trevor Project. So I have put the link in the chat, and it will be in the description on the replay. So it's there. Yeah, and let's get back to this with our Dragoon, Monk, Summoner, and Mime team. We're gonna get our Mime unlocked finally today. It's been a long journey, but we're finally about to get there. So
you actually get to have all four classes, huh?
Yep. All right. So since the last stream, I did go and fill out the Chicken Knife's flea stat. So it is at maximum power now. It took me about 15-20 minutes to do that. But other than that, yeah, we have not done anything, so I think now we are heading to the Wind Shrine. We have a few dungeons to do so we can actually get our Mime. Alright, so as far as jobs go, I mean, we spent basically all of our money getting Hermes sandals for everyone. Yep. We did get our Holy Lance, which is like the only weapon we're actually using right now from our stash.
It's fine.
Yeah, it'll be okay. Alright, I don't really need to like fight too hard in here, but what's up, Witchy Kiss? Oh yeah, we have to kill these guys. So the best way to do this is probably gonna be to Air Knife summon Syldra. Or we don't actually have Syldra yet, do we?
No, you could go get Syldra.
Yeah, you know what? We should probably do that.
You could go get Syldra.
Yeah, we should probably do that first.
I would recommend that. I mean, you won't want to use it against the boss, but still.
Yeah. You're at work still? Well, hopefully this will make work a little bit less a pain in the ass. Because you get to be here with me. Yeah, I'm the greatest.
That's definitely an opinion.
It's the only opinion. Do you have the actual stream pulled up to verify if this sound is okay?
Yeah, give me a sec.
Alright.
Let me go unmute it.
Syldra's alive. Sort of. Not really. See, Krell sees it. Alright. Come on.
Hold on, alright, hold on. Yeah, alright, sounds fine.
Yeah, alright, Syldra.
Oh, we got a Syldra? Nice.
Yep. It is like the most powerful weapon on our team.
Yeah, kinda.
Because it gets boosted with the air knife, and the only thing that does like more damage than that is Bahamut, which we don't have.
Well, there's also Leviathan, is actually higher damage as well.
Okay, well, we don't have Leviathan yet either, so...
No. And Syldra boosted is better than either of those two not boosted.
Yeah.
And boosting Leviathan is very difficult because only a few things can boost water. There's no equipment that does it that I'm aware of.
So how exactly would you boost Leviathan?
I know at least one method is that there's
Is
a
it a chemist
chemist
drink?
mix. Yeah,
Yeah.
there's a chemist drink that boosts all elements, and since water is an element, that counts. And there might be like one other specific thing. It's very difficult, let's just put it that way.
Should probably make sure that they actually have summon on. Yeah. Okay, we're all good here. We're all good in the hood. They are not going to survive this attack.
Probably not.
That was a fight, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, they're supposed to get easier as you go.
Yeah. So here's the cool thing. We're at the point where basically every encounter can just be solved by summoning Syldra on them, so.
Like, literally, except the boss you're gonna fight.
Yeah.
You will want to be a little more careful with the boss.
Yeah, we might actually have to fight for real. So, this chest is really easy to miss.
There's a lot of easy to miss chests in here.
Ah, fuck this.
Get wrecked by your own people.
This is going south very quickly. Yeah, I mean, if we just like spam summon Syldra at everything, we'll probably gain a bajillion levels. I did not really buy a lot of potions here, so.
I even told you last time that you needed to stock up.
I don't really. I really don't. I don't have the money to do so at the moment. All
mean,
right.
that is accurate. You do not have the money.
This chest can be randomly one of two bosses.
I'm surprised you're going to bother fighting it.
It's a chest. Let's open it.
Ooh. Yeah, it's usually the other one for me. I don't think I've even actually seen this one yet.
Da da na 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 da na 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 da da na na na. Fight!
The hilarious thing is, like, half your party can't boost Syldra because they can't even wield the knives.
Yeah. I am actually surprised he hasn't died yet.
Your world 3 should have health now.
Yeah, we're talking big boy numbers. Like tens of thousands of health. I think this one has a gimmick to it. Yeah, there we go.
Oh, does it also do the illusion thing?
Yep. But it is not going to matter, so suck it.
Apparently, only one of them still exists.
Yeah. Yeah, nailed it. And it's the
Rising Sun.
yeah, the Rising Sun can be used by our mime, I guess, but I'm not really going to, so.
It's kind of underpowered for this point in the game. It's a little unfortunate because it could seems like it would be a cool weapon, but it's just like not powerful enough.
That 9,000 gil actually helps a lot. Now we actually have some money to go and get high potions before we go too far. We still have one more chest, I think.
Yeah, you should have one more room.
Yep. That was an elixir, that's good. We actually need those. Flip this one to go up, and this should be out now.
Sheesh.
Yeah, we just murderized him.
Yeah, you did.
So yeah, since we're so close here, now that I actually have money for this, I need to go and buy these things.
Why is this where you chose to go buy stuff?
I always go to Phantom Village. Because it's the place where I just know where it's going to have what I want, so. I can't be bothered to remember the locations of other towns in World 3. There we go, that should be fine. Maybe like. Another Phoenix Down would be not a bad idea.
Okay. The one that you can afford?
Yeah, I can afford one and I'm gonna buy it, damn it. Alright, now we're in a much better position going forward here. We can just run through Spam Soldier until we get to the boss and then actually fight for real. By the time we get out, we should have a giant stack of doubloons. Yeah, well, ideally, we're not gonna die, Zoe, so. But you never know when something really bad is about to happen, like level 5 death, and you're not prepared for it.
I mean, you are hell-bent on fighting these guys, and I'm pretty sure they know level 3 flare.
Yeah,
that's bad for your health.
What's really bad for my health is that I'm right around level 30, so... yeah, we're vulnerable to basically every spell at level 30. We got, what, level 2 old, level 5 death, level 3 flare, and... Is there another
you
one?
You miss level 4 Gravika.
Okay, yeah, thank God.
That's pretty much your only saving grace.
Alright. So we're gonna, like, just fucking plow through all this stuff now. Because we have, like, turbo summon spam on, so there's, like, almost no enemies that could actually pose a threat to us at this point. But the ones that can, oh god. Where are we at? Level 6 monk, 4 monk, and 1 dragoon. Yeah. Okay. So yeah, there is one chest on the right and one on the left. The one on the right requires us to go through the wall. Yeah, and I think that's what, a protect ring, and that's protected by a prototype.
The one in the middle?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes. Well, actually, I don't think it's a prototype, I think it's a mecha head, but yeah.
Yeah.
Actually, it might randomly be a prototype or a mecha head. So you might get lucky, or unlucky. Ah, crystal helm.
Yep. Zildra does make this really satisfying, like, laser sound.
That kind of is the point.
Alright. Yeah, it's a prototype.
Oh, yeah, you got a prototype.
Called it.
I think it is randomly one or the other.
So this has, like, 6,000 health, and I think the mecha head has more.
5, actually.
5, yeah, okay.
But the mecha head has lower defenses. It's actually easier to kill. This thing is weak to lightning, but you didn't seem to care enough.
Nope. I think it had dropped something, but I didn't see what it was.
It would have been a dark matter. It's the only thing it drops.
Oh, well then, yeah, we got a dark matter, so hooray.
Actually, I think it always drops a dark matter, if I recall correctly.
Yeah, it doesn't drop the coolest dark matter, which is dark matter 2525.
I didn't get that one.
He makes really awesome videos that do, some of them are more like just like actually talking, but most, like, yeah, the thing he's probably most known for is his animations, where he has the little angel Jeffrey and the god Yahweh, and kind of taking the piss out of religion, but trying to, like, make it seem as absurd as it actually is. And he does a very good job of it. So, like, some of them are more, like, comical, but like some of them, but he has also like a really like kind of long and in-depth like storyline about it too, and the animation is like really good. So, and he's been around on YouTube for a really long time. Also, he looks kind of like a Viking, and that's pretty awesome.
I mean, that's never a bad thing.
Yeah, no, he's, like, really, really smart, and his opinions are definitely, like, top shelf, and animations are also really great to watch, too, so. Definitely, it's one of my favorite YouTubers. Okay. I'm going to remember how to get these, I swear.
I'm kind of hoping you don't.
Are you that far behind where that's what you need?
I still haven't progressed again. I've been kind of... Actually, you know what it is? I got caught up in a Steam game called Halls of Torment.
Oh.
But I've basically finished that now, so probably tomorrow I'll get back to my run, if not later today. Because I'm still off tomorrow.
Nailed it. First try. Don't at me. We've been using a lot of mana here, so we probably need to get some of it back.
Yeah. Pretty sure Krill was about to be out of mana, actually.
Yeah.
But that's better now.
Oh. I mean, I know some of the people watching actually know Dark Matter, because he's been on Drunken Peasants a few times. him, and he also does like a podcast with another person whose name I should definitely remember, and I fucking can't for some reason. Look, we got another dark matter. It's a sign. It's the game. It's like, yeah, I agree. Yeah, see, Witchy Kiss knows what's going on. Yeah, Jeffrey the Angel is really cool.
Recircle it. All right, now it's time for the boss.
Yep. Hadouken! Alright. Yeah, we're not gonna be doing that for the boss. Alright.
You're gonna wanna maybe change your equipment a bit.
Yes. Okay. Try this with focus, I think. Does it absorb holy, or is it just wind?
I don't think so.
I think that the holy lance should be okay.
If yeah, not, I think you're all right.
Well, if not, we'll change it mid-combat, so. Alright. We're good. Are you fucking kidding me? It's not boosted anymore, so now it didn't kill all of them.
Yeah. Alright, time to watch you get wrecked.
Nah, it's gonna be fine. Oops. Nope, that one's real. Okay. That one was real.
Wow, that did nothing.
Yeah, that was pretty pathetic. Let's take a shot in the dark. Yeah, that was great.
Oh. Yeah, there you go.
That was totally random, too.
He's not particularly powerful. He's only got, like, 20,000 health, I think.
Yeah. Alright. I choose you. Nope.
He's getting that really fast, too. Holy cow.
Oops, nope. Come back. Come back. Alright. I think it's this one. Nope. It's the first one. Okay. Try this one this time. I guess we're just gonna counter the real one.
Well, it's still there, so it doesn't move from a counterattack.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, that's a problem.
Nope, it's fine.
Well,
she figured it out.
Yeah. She did solve her own problem.
Figure it out, dude! Alright.
Oh, get wrecked.
Kinda surprised it's not dead yet.
Yeah, same here. Go. Oh, there they go.
Nailed it.
And you got the quick kill, too.
Woohoo! That's 20 ability points. That's actually quite a lot here.
Yeah, a lot of the bosses in World 3 are just worth a ton of AP.
Yeah, that's right. We killed the spooky ghosts. That's why there's so much ectoplasm everywhere. Now we get to do Fork Tower next. Which,
I mean, I just want to point out that technically speaking, your primary summon is a spooky ghost.
That is also
like,
true.
Sildra is literally dead.
What the fuck?
Ah, yes, now you get to figure this problem out.
Oh. People are messaging me while I'm like, I told them, it's like, I'm going to be busy streaming, so... Oh, no, this should be fine. We've got physical attackers, and we have Reflect on Carbuncle, so, yeah, we're fine. So much drama, so little time. Egghead, are you the one that like tagged me that I didn't look at? I bet it's John, isn't it? I already know, probably just from like those three words, like what the problem is, like half the time.
Well, he says you're wrong.
Okay.
Oh wait, no, he does say it was John.
How the fuck did I know that? Alright. Yeah, everybody watching, this is why being a mod for, like, anything is not as glamorous as you would think, because it's... All that will happen is that people will cause you grief and you get, like, nothing for doing it. So... Yeah. It's like almost always an unpaid position to just deal with other people's nonsense, and you get nothing from it. So.
Yeah, I don't know why you enjoy being a mod.
It's not that I enjoy it, it's that it's something that's necessary in order to mean, or for the things that you enjoy to like not fall to shit. Because case in point, this is happening. But like, and yeah, like a lot of people will, it happens, I know, on the Wendy server, for instance, a lot, because, yeah, if you guys didn't know, I am one of the moderators for the, like, actual Wendy's, corporate Discord servers. And there are a lot of people that are like, make me a mod, and I'm like, you really don't want that. It's not worth it, trust me. But sometimes, like, it's a matter of like, okay, well, if I'm not gonna do it, then do I actually just trust the rest of the world to do a better job? And a lot of times the answer is no. The people who do the best job at that are the people who don't really want to be doing it in the first place. And that's actually true for basically any position of authority. The people who want to be doing it are the ones that absolutely should not ever be doing it in the first place. Because they're the ones most likely to abuse the station, so.
Yeah.
Like, the presidency, for instance. We have a really, really bad system that encourages basically all the wrong people to try to be president because they have money to do it. So the people who would probably do the best job are the ones that like don't have the money interest that they're trying to protect, so. That's why, like, George Washington was probably one of the best presidents that the United States will have ever had, because my understanding is he did not want to be president in the first place, and, like, he basically, like, kept nagging him until he did it.
He didn't even, well, they didn't even want him to be president. They basically wanted to elect him King of America.
Right,
and
yeah.
And he's like, bitch, that's not how we do this anymore.
Yeah. It's like, that is the exact kind of person who should be at that sort of post. And, that's not really the world that we live in, so. And like, even like on a small scale, like on a Discord mod or something, like, or, you know, the dreaded, like, Reddit mods. The people who really, like, want to go out of their way to do it, again, yeah, they're the people you really don't want doing it.
As long as we're on the subject, do you have any idea why the 4job Fiesta Reddit got shut down?
Yes, actually, I do. It has to do with the API changes that Reddit was pushing forward, which my understanding is that they're still trying to do this, and it's, I think, long-term going to blow up in their faces, because they're basically trying to monetize the ability to access data from their site by, or any third-party application that would be doing calls to, like, pull or data, or, like or to, like, let you, you know, use, like, a third-party app to post to Reddit, for instance, or something like that. Yeah, well, they want those app developers to have to pay for every, like, yeah, for the amount of traffic that they're putting through their thing. And it's not a good idea for that, because a lot of, like, one reason is a lot of the subreddits have mod tools that they use that are, like, third-party apps. And they use these API calls, but if they had to pay for them, like, the fucking developers of those apps are not going to do it, so those apps are just fucking going to collapse into nothing. And I believe Reddit has said that they will make a replacement set of those tools and stuff, but, like any sort of, like, you know, other application, like, a lot of people have apps that they like to use for Reddit and stuff, and, it's just not really a good idea to limit access to that information, because it's basically people making content and driving traffic to your site, and by trying to, like, monetize it, you're actually killing traffic to your own site, as well as making your users' lives more difficult and making and creating an opening in the market for another platform to step in. Kind of like, you know, how Twitter has done exactly that, and now Threads is, like, a thing. There's also Blue Sky, which is in beta. Apparently, yeah, the Reddit team does not understand this, and they're fucking around, and they're gonna find out. So, RK did not, he did not want the 4job Fiesta site to be open and supporting Reddit's hate against third-party projects, like, you know, the fucking Fiesta that we do, so.
Yeah, I only found this out recently because, like, I was doing Google searches looking for, like, online information to help me out with my Beastmasters, because I'm not as well versed in them. And apparently there's, like, a whole Beastmaster guide someone wrote on Reddit that I can see via Google but cannot access because it's in the server that's now shut down. And I was like, shit.
I think here we want the summoners to have HP plus 20%.
Yeah, you tell me. they're fighting Omniscient, I guess.
Yeah, well, they'll just, they're,
if you think you need the health,
they're just gonna cast Reflect on themselves and they'll be fine. I think the other two should probably be sufficient. I mean, I probably could take Omniscient with one summoner, but I don't feel like taking that risk.
A little ballsy.
Yeah, whereas again, I don't really want them summoning on the other side, so probably counter is not a well, she's a monk, she already has it, but HP plus 10% is fine, and yeah, and either counter or barehanded would probably be fine for the Dragoon. Or he just
I would recommend counter, just because you're going to get attacked a lot by the boss, and that'll help you get free damage in.
Yeah.
Because, like, you're gonna be taking damage pretty hard against the boss. You might even want to move your monk to the back row.
Yeah. So here's the fun part. All of them can stay in the back row. It's totally fine. But
if you throw, do you have focus on the monk? Because I think that ignores Ro.
Or
do
you
have HP up?
You know what? That's not a bad call, actually. This is a really good focus area.
I suppose that could also work for the Dragoon, but they also have jump.
Yeah. Okay. So we just have to remember that Bart and Ferris are going to the left and Lena and Krill go to the right. You are going this way.
Magicus is part of the Rebel Alliance and a traitor. Take him away.
Krill goes to the side. All right, we have our teams.
This is, in my opinion, one of the most significant challenges in World 3. Once you get through this, everything else becomes a lot easier.
All right, we're still in the back row. That's good. I just need to make sure I don't accidentally, like, have them attacking on auto battle.
Yeah, that would go very poorly.
Oh, come on.
Are they both equipped with air knives?
Oh, you know what? They are not. Oh, fuck. Egghead, if he's being a pat, yeah, let's just fucking send him to the garbage island. Yeah, the Drunken Peasants Discord has a special channel in it that, yeah, it's basically like a drunk tank. So
you have a dunce corner.
We actually do. It's like the floating garbage pile that's in the middle of the Pacific Ocean. We call it Garbage Island. And that's where everybody... Yeah, if you go in the drunk tank, that's where you go. Yeah, this is also true, Egghead. You are allowed to do things without my permission. It would be nice if I wasn't the only one that had to, like, deal with this stuff. As far as I'm concerned, I've given him, like, a bajillion chances to fucking shape up or ship out, so Whatever fucking fate befalls this guy, it's on him. There we go. We got the Wonder Wand, which is actually going to be very useful for us later.
Is it? Oh, what, just for Shinryu?
Yeah. Did I take off my Hermes sandals?
You probably optimized at some point without paying attention.
It did.
Because they don't optimize on.
That's correct. I can't save you from the cosmic nightmare because you're I'm living in it just as much as you are, and I'm not high, so. Oops, not that one. Hermes sandals. There we go. I do have another gold hairpin. That's right. I should use it.
Yeah, you probably should.
Alright. I mean, this fight should be pretty easy. As long as I don't fuck around, like, it's pretty straightforward.
You're not gonna find out.
Yeah. Alright. They're still good.
Just be careful that they don't accidentally summon by on auto battle.
Yeah, we don't want that. Does the Berserker also drop the Death Sickle?
I have no idea.
Climb the scary mountain and go kill the Minotaur's brother. Well, yeah, we fought one of them in the.
Yeah, you fought Tekmet. This is the Minotaur.
Yeah. Then this side has, I think, the Defender on it, which is actually another really good weapon.
Yeah, but you can't use it. Oh, well, I guess you could with your...
I could, but I'd also have... I have Sasuke's Katana, so... It's not really necessary for me to use it.
Well, it's actually sort of nice, though, because if you use it as an item in battle, it casts Protect.
That's kind of good.
Which, I mean, I guess you could do that with your mime to get Protect on some of your people, if you felt the need.
Can you imagine how cool it would be to have mime and ninja here? I have all these cool weapons, but I'm limited to using one.
Yeah. I mean, you could swap around, but you still only get the one.
These guys are not exactly easy to run from.
No, normally you would have the chicken knife on someone here to help with that. Which reminds me, why are you not using the chicken knife on her?
Apparently they do drop the Death Sickle because I just got one, so.
Alright, well, good to know.
Well, the monk cannot use the chicken knife. But I could actually use focus with it on the Dragoon.
The bigger point, and I'm just being nice by mentioning this, is that the Minotaur absorbs Holy.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's right. Well, I would have found that out anyway, so...
Yeah, you would have fucked around and you would have found out, but... It's...
All right.
Figured I'd be nice and just tell you ahead of time. still find it hilarious that he can't cast it, though. Even though he tries.
Alright. Let's go.
Yeah, honestly, like, it depends on the group that you have, but in my opinion, most of the time, the Minotaur is actually the harder fight, even though Omniscient is the more technical fight.
That was a lot. Well, it was. Yeah, this guy is going down like a sack of potatoes. Yep, there he goes. He's dead.
Wow, get obliterated.
Focus with the chicken knife is pretty awesome.
Yeah, holy cow.
Do-do-do-do-do-do. Yeah, I got white magic holy, which I can't use at all.
It's fine.
I actually have to interact with this thing in 5 seconds or I die.
Why'd you walk out?
Because I can, just to prove that it's possible for me to do that. You can start running backwards through the dungeon if you choose.
Now let's see how many times your reflect runs out at a bad time. Oh yeah, especially since you can't see when it's up because of your haste. Yeah.
Well, let's just hope that it doesn't.
That's very inconvenient. In the GBA version, it would actually show the reflect over the haste. Well, I guess you'll figure that one out.
I'm just gonna kill him before Reflect runs out. That's the plan.
You hope. I mean, you'll never know the difference anyway until he murders you.
Okay, that sounds like Reflect ran out.
Sounds like you just died.
Yeah, it ran out at a really, really bad time.
All right, so that's one on the count of Reflect running out at a bad moment. I like how you accidentally triggered an autosave because you walked out of the room that helps you here.
Okay, well,
like you should have to do both fights over again.
Well, you know what? Maybe that's just my Giga Brain strategy here.
Yeah, you did not do that intentionally.
You know what?
You're not getting to that one.
This is happening now. Reflect can't run out if I just cast it every turn.
That's a strategy, I guess.
He only has, like, what, 17,000 health, so this will still kill him pretty quickly anyway.
Something like that.
It's like 8 rounds of combat and he dies, so... Oh, look, I cast Reflect. Alright, there you go. That was critical.
The real question is, will your mana last long enough for this?
Oh yeah, he's already, like, in Fireaga phase.
God, he does so little damage to himself.
Yeah, well, it really doesn't matter, because he does all of the final damage to himself.
Oh, yeah, there it is.
Goodbye, magic carpet. Obtain the black magic flare. Now we can finally get our submarine.
Yep.
And we can get the mime class, which we have desperately wanted this whole time.
Oh yeah, it is mime o'clock.
Alright.
Yeah, I do feel you're pretty much obligated to do that next, because you kind of need to get your class.
Sid, what are you doing? You're gonna ruin the catapult. I don't know how you upgrade an airship with submarine functionality. That just doesn't sound like a thing. Oh yeah, this is where we get Krill in mid shipping.
Is that really what you're calling this conversation?
I mean, sort of. They're bonding. They're both
they're
like...
They're bonding.
Yeah, they're both like grandkids of characters here. Yeah, you can't fight for beans, I'm sure. Yeah, well, there's a lot of stuff that's underwater that we can get to now. A lot of very useful stuff.
Indeed.
Like another Aegis shield. And my last class. Finally.
And another summon.
Mm-hmm.
Now that's true. You could have already gone to get Bahamut, but you didn't. And Phoenix.
No, I did not mean to fly into that.
Good job. We're going in, guys.
It's okay. This is a false alarm. We just have to get rid of the cutscene. That's all. It only happens one time. Bye.
Yeah, never mind, we were just kidding.
There's a whole bunch of those like on the map right now, and that's just the one that actually is a real portal.
Yeah, it's the one at Tycoon Castle is the real one.
Okay. Where? Oh, no. We flew up too far.
Leah, what are you doing? Are you looking for the water shrine?
Yeah, it's actually over this way, right?
I think so. It's hard for me to tell where you are on the map.
I think it's here?
Yeah, it should be just north. North. Or maybe. No, maybe not.
You know what? I'm not really intending to fight a whole lot of things here. I think it's like...
No, yeah, you might be right. It's somewhere down here. Just go underwater. You'll be able to see it that way.
Yeah, there it is. Oh, no. Hold your breath for 7 minutes. That is a really long time to hold your breath.
Yeah.
Especially when you're fighting and getting the shit kicked out of you. Uh-oh. Oh, John's about to get kicked in the teeth for this one.
Oh.
He did, like, the one thing that you are absolutely not allowed to do. Which is, circumvent getting sent to Garbage Island. Oops. Oh, yeah, actually, no, that chest is extra air, which we don't need right now.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure all of the chests in here are extra air. I don't think there are any actual items.
I think there's only one chest, and it's that one, and it's extra air.
Is there only one? I thought there was a second one.
I think that's the only one. Now, if you'll remember, when this tower sank, the crystal shard was actually at the top of it, so the fact that it's not there should suggest to the player, there's some fishy nonsense going on here. It has taken the first two acts, but now the amazing power of this crystal shard is within my competent grasp. Turn back and be gone! I shan't allow you to take it. Will you heed my warning? Fuck you. I do what I want. Alright. So the important thing here is to do absolutely nothing. Because if you do anything, you will piss him off and he will attack you back for a lot. And if you really piss him off, then he will extremely attack you and kill you. With, like, triple casting meteor. You definitely don't want to do that. Also, famed Mimic Gogo is actually, I think, one of the characters in Final Fantasy VI, so.
Oh, really?
I think he is one of the party members you can get, yeah. If you punch him, he will physically attack you for, like, maximum damage and kill you in one hit. If you use magic in him, he'll use, like, Flare or Holy or something on you, which will also probably kill you.
Yeah, he's pretty strong.
He has, like, 32,000 health or something like that. And, yeah, once he gets, like, halfway dead, then he goes into, like, super rage mode, and then, yeah, he just starts, like, triple casting meteors and stuff, so it's not a good time. Don't fuck with him. Just, if you sit here and do nothing, you win the fight. Though, canonically, I like to believe my party is just hearing because it's all underwater anyway. So they didn't hear a word he said, and they were just like, what? Yeah! Alright, now we actually have to use Mime.
Yep.
Well, I mean, once you have Mime, it's actually pretty awesome. Oops.
You do not equip Mime, sir.
You sort of do. where are you here?
Pretty sure it's at the end, yeah.
At least until Bart's, like, masters enough summon stuff. Okay, so we have some options here. We definitely want to give him summon. You always keep item. Probably focus is a good one here.
Just replace attack with focus.
Yeah, and either counter barehanded or HP plus 20% is the other call. I'm going to say barehanded because I want my mime. Well,
do you not need to equip, don't you need to equip items, or do you lose it? Do you still have items?
Items is the one you keep.
Oh, well then why is it available as an option?
I don't fucking know. You get 3. Like, I don't think you need to equip items because you have 4 attacks, and it replaces attack in your 2 abilities, right?
Right. I think you're right.
This is the... Well, I haven't mastered Monk, so yeah, I need barehanded if I want them to hit strong. Here I can use any weapon I want.
And shields.
Wait, do I not have the Excalibur? Why can't I use it?
Hang on, wait. No, go back to your job selection.
Yeah.
Go to...
Well, they don't get to use...
They actually don't get anything, everything.
Ooh, wow, that's gonna make this a little bit more...
Actually, it looks like they don't get swords at all.
Get knives. All right, hold on.
How weird.
Let me check the actual, like, full list here. Knives, rods, boomerangs, staves.
Looks like whips, I think.
Doesn't... I don't think so. The flail is on there, I think, is... Yeah, but...
Oh, is that what that is?
Yeah, but it's actually listed under staves. Okay, well, actually, fuck, okay, well, we don't actually get to use all the cool stuff I wanted to use. The Freelancer would get to, but the Mime doesn't.
Yeah, the Freelancer actually equips... See, I didn't think that the Mime actually could equip every item. I thought that was specific to the Freelancer.
Well, we can get some stuff, like...
You could... Well, you could switch the chicken knife over to them.
Yeah, I can do that. Oh, yeah, Bart says it. Nope.
No, it's on Krill right now because you didn't. You had to take off the Holy Lance.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I guess I don't actually need the tablets then.
No. I guess you don't need to go back for most of them, or any of them, really.
Yeah. That's... I do need this though. Well, since the Mime can use the gold hairpin, he probably should.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, your Mime now doubles as a physical attacker and a melee attacker. Or, and a magic attacker.
Yep. Okay. You know what? This is fine. Oh, we can't go out the front door anymore.
Nope, you gotta backtrack and not drown.
Well, we haven't even used half of the time yet. But I still need to go get Leviathan anyway, and there's an Aegis shield for my Mime there, so that's definitely still on the menu. Like, we still have at least three more optional dungeons that we do want to finish. It just means that the fourth one is not really... We don't care about it.
Yeah. Unless you want to get the Kaiser Knuckles.
I don't think I do, because like
one thing that's
I'd
there.
Actually have to give up haste, and I couldn't even use the Mazamune to cast haste on him. So.
Yeah, that hurts a lot.
If I had the Mazamune to use haste on the monk, I might actually use the Kaiser Knuckles, but...
Yeah, I get that.
More actions is usually better than just, like, more powerful actions.
Yeah, because you can give them summon anyway, and they can still do decent damage.
Yep.
I forget, did you go get the magic lamp?
I have not. That is actually still on our list. We don't actually need to, because we have Summoner, but we may as well.
You do need it if you want to be able to insta-kill the one thing in the Neo X death fight, because you can't do that naturally.
We should go get it, just because... I mean, it's close.
Yeah, the game won't let you use Zantetsuken in that fight naturally.
We're going in that direction anyway, so. There we go. We've made it back to the ship. We've managed to avoid drowning.
Have you ever even played one of those games?
Nope. I don't even know that I know which game it's from.
Oh my god. Specifically, that's from Metal Gear Solid 2. It's actually a game I'm rather fond of.
I really like the music from Metal Gear Solid, or what is it? Metal Gear Rising.
Yeah, no, that shit's pretty good. Though, to be fair, I think even the music in the regular series is pretty good.
Yeah.
It's just not as hardcore. Okay.
So, if I remember, okay, so we have to walk back around.
Yeah, now comes the part where we see if you remember how to even get there.
Yeah, okay, we have to walk.
Currently, the answer is no.
I forgot that I could take him in here. No, don't fucking chase him away. I need him. Egghead, you should have some ice cream and cake in order to relax.
I have ice cream. I could go have ice cream.
Well, I specifically mean ice cream and cake.
No, I just have cookies and cream.
So, one of the things is that Benpai on the DP server, like, I think, said he doesn't like cake and ice cream together. So when I was out shopping last night, I was kind of like live texting my shopping trip to the server, and they're all like encouraging me, you need to go get cake and ice cream. So I bought like strawberries and strawberry glaze and fucking ice cream and cake and some like sponge cake, and I fucking made some awesome strawberry shortcake. I had my fucking cake and ice cream, and it was amazing.
And you ate it too.
Yeah. Better believe it, dude. I warmed that fucking sponge cake up first and put the ice cream on top of it so it melted real nice.
I do love how there is literally nothing on the planet that actually motivates you to bother doing anything except spite.
What can I say? It's my number one motivation to do basically anything.
It's not number one, it's like it's the only one.
That's still number one anyway. Egghead, he was using his mobile because he's an idiot and fucking forgot his old account. That's why. I don't think it was out of maliciousness. I think he's just fucking stupid. And or on drugs. Yeah. John from Finland likes to party.
Throw that account on fucking Garbage Island too. Problem solved.
Yeah, that might be the call. I gotta remember what the entrance is in here.
Where are you going? Oh, right.
Yeah, I think we gotta go around.
Yeah, I believe it was down on the bottom. This is one of the dungeons I almost never come back to.
We got like full magic and stuff here. No, we are not, so let's fix that.
I find it weird that they changed it so you have to walk up to the chair to trigger resting. It used to just ask you as soon as you went into the room. Seems like an odd change to program.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, fuck. You know what? I think I have one coral ring. You know, we'll be fine. I have one, and I think... Yeah, we're just going to have to be okay with that.
Did you forget to get more coral rings?
I don't have enough money to buy more coral rings right now.
You probably actually have shit you can sell. You kept getting drops while you were in the island shrine.
Uh... Yeah. Sure. Actually. No, you probably should have summon. You have everything you need. And you probably want to have summon. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, no, whatever Creamsicle said, fucking do it. Oh, actually, I'm supposed to have the mime use focus because, the chicken knife.
I don't know why you're bothering to attack here.
Oh yeah, that's right. No, we do have to pick items because Mimic is equipped.
Oh, they get Mimic as their last slot. Yeah, see, you don't get shit unless you choose to have it.
Okay. I really didn't think that that's how that worked, but...
I don't know, I don't think I've ever really used the Mimic. Bless you.
Ugh.
Stop it.
I mean, I guess this is still fine.
Yeah, I mean, you just can't use items with that character.
It's big deal.
Mostly not that big a deal.
I think we gotta be careful here, though, because I'm pretty sure time berries exist in this area.
Yes, they do.
Fuck.
You just don't fight them, just run away. They're not really that dangerous here.
No, I meant this. I have to actually summon to kill them.
Oh, yeah.
So I came out blasting.
Yeah, they're not exactly that strong, so you're fine.
No, but my monk has pathetic MP. Wait.
No.
No, we just didn't... I thought I healed it. How do we lose that
much? You probably healed it before you put summon on.
Hmm. Yeah, you're right.
Because they would have had pathetic MP before you had summon on, but then it would have gone up when you put equip summon.
I don't know if this is actually going to work on all these things. There might be if some things in here that are immune to this, I don't remember.
Yeah, it could be possible. I mean, it's wind, not water, so it's not like it's super probable, but...
Alright. There is a chest up to the right, and then there is this one. Oh, I think she gets really angry if you kill the toad before her.
I'm not sure. You might find out.
Yeah, I think she really does like go like super aggressive if the toad dies before she does.
Yeah, well, it looks like she has less health than it does, so that's not probably going to be a problem.
Yeah.
As long as you're only using AoE attacks, you're fine.
Huh. I guess if they're doing this, they should be holding air knives.
The ones that can, yes.
Well, that's two of them that are currently not, so...
You're just not going to get the other chest?
Oh, fuck. I wanted to get this one first. I forgot what order I have to do it in.
Like, you were literally basically right next to it. All you had to do was go up the stairs, and you skipped it twice.
I thought that those stairs were the way forward, not these ones. Yeah, boosting it helps a lot.
Yeah, no shit. Good job.
I got another dark matter, because this game really loves dark matter. And I got another air knife that I don't need.
The game's calling you an idiot, I think.
Oh, fuck. This is not what
I
want.
Well, you can see how this goes.
No, I really don't want to.
I'm not actually sure that they're that powerful here. He did move closer to you, though, in a menacing way.
Check something. The mime does not get to use the ribbon, does he? Fuck.
I don't think so.
I guess it's only the freelancer and the dancer. Because I should have one in my inventory already.
Yeah, you would have gotten it at Karnak 500.
Yeah.
You've been hanging on to it specifically for this purpose.
Yeah, well, apparently the freelancer gets it, the mime doesn't. So, fuck.
Yeah, you could check that in the game by going to the item.
I could, but... Too late. Mobile accounts banned, these... Garbage Island. Okay, yeah, you know what? Whatever. Fuck him. He's already, like, outright asked me to ban him before, so you know what? I don't give a fuck. He's someone else's problem now. We'll throw him in the fucking garbage pile in the Pacific, along with all of our other problems that we don't know how to deal with as a nation.
I thought maybe they might absorb wind, but nope. And I love that vampire for zero.
Oh no, oh my god, he's so scary. Moyer's favorite skill to use. The Rune Blade.
Rune Blade.
Yeah, I don't think I'm going to be using that.
You literally don't have a sword wielder, so yeah.
Yeah, so. I wonder if I can kill Leviathan with Syldra before his tidal waves kill me.
Probably not. Also, against single targets, theoretically, your mimic using focus chicken knife might probably does more damage.
Very possible.
It's comparable, though. It's hard. It'd be hard to tell.
This is just faster than running from most of these fights.
Yeah, and it's good XP too.
More importantly, it's good GP. Because I still want coral rings for the...
GP, sir.
Your GP or your HP.
You're playing Final Fantasy, it's Gil.
Oh, fuck me. Nope, I don't want to deal with this guy. Run away.
He's coming for you.
He is, and if he stabs me, I will die in one hit. This is also not a guy that you really want to fuck around with. He can, like, old and confuse your characters, I think. There's a reflect ring.
No, reflect ring.
Oh, fuck. Should not have done this.
I don't think he counterattacks. I think you could just kill him.
Yeah, he's not countering me. Okay, so... I'm so traumatized by this enemy and all the other games he shows up in.
That's because every Final Fantasy, they made him successively more dangerous. But this is only Final Fantasy V. He's not that bad yet.
Yeah, I know in 7, if you attack him, like, he will counter literally, like, any attack with everyone's grudge, which will essentially one-shot that character.
Yeah, that's, similar to what happens in FF10. You counterattack one in... When you hit the one in FF10, he counterattacks with Karma, which does damage based on how many enemies you've killed throughout the game.
Oh, yeah, well, that's what everyone's grudge does, so...
He's a tanky sucker.
Yeah, he has, like, a lot of health. I might not actually have enough mana to kill him this way.
Oh, shit, yeah, I just realized what was happening to your mana bars.
He has just under 40,000 health. He is stronger than most fucking bosses in this game.
And Krill has reverted to use just pot attack. Oh, you got him.
He's worth 15 ability points if you kill him, though.
Yeah, that still didn't seem very worthwhile.
Well,
good, the save point. Yeah, you needed this.
I really did, because I had, like, no mana.
Speaking of
left.
Things you need, how about that cottage count?
How about that cottage count? We're going to have to go shopping after this dungeon.
This is don't forget, you're going to have to reset your party because they fell off of some.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, she just told me that I don't get any bitches, and that's not cool. That's like the chick in Elden Ring that's always like, haha, you're maidenless.
Yeah.
Okay, I know there are holes in this floor somewhere.
Pretty sure the holes in the floor were more obvious.
They're like in the middle of the room. Oh, there's a bow I'm not going to be using.
Yep. Oh, you got all your people above 1,000 health now.
That's great. Still not one of them can survive all my guests.
Yeah, very accurate. What is your plan there?
I'm gonna have to Kotoblopos him. that's the plan.
You're just gonna have to get him before he gets a shot off?
That's, yeah. Forget if this is the one. I think this enemy might be immune to this. No, they are not. Never mind.
Nope.
I really thought something in here was. I gotta be careful not. Because I think the hole in the floor was like right there. It's in the middle of that area. Seven ability points for that fight is a pretty good amount. There's an enhancer.
Yeah, oh, there's an enhancer.
Still not using that. And, oh, fuck this.
Your friend.
Yeah, I am not wasting that many magic points trying to kill this fucker.
Yeah, he has way more health than I expected.
He literally has more health than most of the bosses in this game. So we got to hit this button very carefully. Yep. Take our loot. That is an important piece of loot.
Oh, there we go.
Because that actually gives me a chance to just dodge Almagest, or like the tidal wave that I'm about to get hit with.
Yeah. Okay, the monsters I get, but, like, why are there just random ninjas in here?
I think these are more like monks, actually.
I guess.
I think one version of them is literally called Iron Fist. Alright.
Worthless Shuriken.
Ninjas are everywhere.
We got time for you.
It's true. Well, okay, so... fun fact... Alright, there's a Titan Axe. I'm not using that, but we have it. There was one time in my life when I was just driving down the road and I saw a woman dressed in, like, full fucking black, like, ninja garb just jogging down the road. So, the fact that I was able to see a ninja... means that I'm at least part ninja. Like, I'm like ninja apprentice for being able to just see a ninja.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
I'm not convinced that's how that works.
I mean, it is. I didn't make the rule. That's just how it is. Oh, yeah. Oh, no, the boss. What are we ever gonna do?
I was always curious what monster this was supposed to be.
Pretty sure Jesus said that. Yeah, Jesus is the one that said, if thou sees a ninja, thou becomes thy ninja's apprentice. That's his, the 11th commandment, right?
My favorite thing about this is the fact that you could just walk away at this point. You don't have to interact with Leviathan at all.
I did.
He just shows up to save your bacon and you just be like, thanks, and then leave.
I didn't equip the coral ring before I talked to him.
Oh man, this is gonna end so poorly.
Fight! Alright, here we go, it's the race. Oh god.
Well, he counterattacks with it. So it's not so much a race as you dying.
Yep.
Alright, each of them dodged it once. Can they continue to dodge it for the next, I don't know, 30,000 health?
He has 40,000 health, actually.
Yeah, we already hit him a few times.
Come on. Oh, that's bad. All right.
Nope.
You know what I should be doing? I should just put my mime with focus punching the chicken knife with the ring on, because then I basically can't die. Sadly, I knew how that was going to go the second that I clicked the button, because I forgot to do the thing, so. It's okay.
Get wrecked, sir.
Let's take our tablet again. The rest of the party can die, it doesn't matter. I will survive with my mime, because my mime will keep getting healed. And it won't take that many attacks, because Focus Punch Chicken Knife is real good. Alright, let's get our fucking summoning. Do it right this time.
I like how the shield came up as though they blocked it, but they still healed anyway.
Yeah, I think healing overwrites, like, the Aegis shield, so.
Yeah.
Okay, I can't lose this fight. Okay, never mind. I might actually lose this fight. Oh my god! I could actually lose this fight, fuck. Why am I not in the back row for this?
Well, I mean, that still seems like a solvable problem, but you're still in auto battle for some reason.
Yeah, I am. I guess third time's the charm. I didn't know that Leviathan would actually punch me, and especially not for that much damage.
To be fair, you could actually pay attention to the fight and use Golem.
I could, but why would I do that?
You know, because you're supposed to actually play the game like it matters and not play every boss fight in auto battle after the first round.
Well, you know what? Don't fucking tell me what to do.
I have Beastmasters. I have to actually try. You just put the game in auto battle and just don't give a shit.
I really don't. I mean, I could use one of these. I actually don't.
Well, they're better evasion.
I don't need the Aegis shield for this. I just need this. Alright. Once more with feeling.
If you want, you could also double check to see if you have a better helmet, because I think the gold hairpin's actual defense sucks.
Yeah, probably. Yeah, I mean, that is better.
Oh, you can go all the way to freaking heavy. Jeez.
Alright, let's do this. This time's the real one. Last time it was my little brother. He's playing with my hands behind my back, and I wasn't even looking, and it was snowing out.
I still recommend throwing a golem out before you all die.
So needy.
Just for good measure.
Alright, well, I was trying to stop that before that happened, but whatever.
I kind of expected you to get murdered before that happened, but... Yeah,
so did I. Like, I didn't think it was going to matter.
He's just chosen not to counterattack lately. There it is.
Alright.
Also, you are unfortunately very slow with the coral ring on, but I mean, it just is what it is.
Yeah.
The damage is there. Oh, that's bad.
You know what? The more tidal waves, the merrier. I probably should cast Golem on my next turn.
That would require playing the game. I thought you were just like, ah, that's for suckers.
Well, as it turns out, I don't want to have to fight this a fourth time.
Shit, it knows Aqua Breath.
Oh yeah, Aqua Breath is not an aqua attack, actually.
No, it is not. It just does times 8 damage to desert type monsters is what it does. It itself, I think, is otherwise non-elemental. It can't even hit you.
Yeah, that actually is not pleasant. But as long as you're gonna heal it, then that's cool, man.
There we go.
Ta-da. See, never...
Third time was the time.
Never did I not have it.
You definitely didn't have it several times.
Yeah, GG, idiot water god. Get fucked. I'm probably never even going to use Leviathan anyway, because Soldiers are so much better with the air knife.
Yeah, the only thing it would be good for is if you wanted to go farm in the trench, because some of the enemies there are weak to water.
Yeah.
But you're probably not going to the trench at this rate, so...
I probably don't even need Phoenix at this point, to be honest. I could just skip it.
It's up to you.
Let's see. You're currently...
I'm definitely not going to argue with you spending more time playing the game, but...
Yeah, you really need to catch up badly.
But, I mean, I haven't really started catching up yet, so it might go better for me than I think it will. But I don't think it's going to. We'll just see how hard I can abuse Beastmasters.
Okay, let's get out of here. So we're at, like, what, an hour and 40 minutes? I don't think I'm going to get through the rift tonight.
No. You always think that this is going to take less time than it does.
It really feels like it should.
Like, it's only a handful of dungeons, but then every dungeon is like 45 minutes.
I probably could use a couple more rods now.
And maybe you'll remember that you need to get cottages.
Yeah, maybe. The only thing is that this fucking tower is going to be such a pain in the ass to go through. should be more than enough.
Yeah, I'm not even convinced you really need them for most things. So what you doing in Phantom Village?
They don't sell cottages, do they?
Nope, they're the one that doesn't. Because they sell elixirs instead.
Yep, but I do need to get, at least one more coral ring?
Yeah, you probably should get as many more of those as you can.
So I have two now, and then I will get one in the void itself.
Yeah, you do get one in the void if you want to wait for that one. You should have a bunch of shit to sell. Are you not going to bother to sell any of your stuff?
Not here. I don't need to.
I thought you would just get the fourth coral ring.
No, I'm going to get it before I need it anyway, so it's fine.
I guess.
Alright, now I just got to remember where I can buy a cottage from. I know where.
Right, you just passed a place.
Maybe I want to go to
this. I guess this works too.
Yeah, we'll go to this one.
Will you?
If I can land in the water, then yes.
Yeah, that should do.
See, I don't need to sell Dink. I've got everything I need. How many elixirs do I have? Should be enough.
28. A lot. Jeez. So what's the plan? Are you going to get Bahamut?
I should. These guys had the nerve to attack me.
They moon-fluted you.
That was not the right plan, my guy. You don't want none of what I got.
You should probably put your ring, your Hermes sandals back on Varus.
Yes, I should definitely do that. I guess let's do Bahamut first.
Oh, are you just gonna do both of them?
I think I'm going to, yeah. And that will leave us exactly the rift to do on our last stream, so.
That gives me a week to catch up.
Yeah.
Which shouldn't be too hard. Once I just have to actually sit down and play the game.
All right, North Mountain, let's go. None of these enemies are worth fighting.
Oh yeah, that's right. It doesn't update the enemies in here.
Nothing changes about the map or the enemies. Only Bahamut.
You just get to the top and he's like, surprise.
Yeah, the Gala Cat, if I recall, is one of the enemies that can actually confuse you. Or, I mean, it can float you, I think, yeah.
Yeah, you confuse it and it casts float on you sometimes.
You can use the Dancing Dagger to get float from it.
It's that's actually the release for it if you capture it as a Beastmaster. I can float on purpose that way.
Oh, that's good.
Although I have no idea how I would capture one. That's a slightly different problem, but actually, I guess at that point I would just take my weapons off completely and punch it.
Yeah, it's not a bad call.
I think it's actually weak enough that I could get away with that.
Underappreciated entry, yeah. Final Fantasy V is an amazing game. I love it.
It is great.
God damn it.
You fucked up. Right at the end, too.
Alright.
I mean, you needed to use a cottage anyway, but still, it's funny.
Alright. I should be able to... I can reflect Bahamut, right? That's the play here.
Yes, you can reflect Mega Flare, or Giga Flare, or whichever fucking one it does.
Zeta Flare, whatever.
Well, if I recall correctly, it uses one naturally, and I think it counters magic with the other one. So I think you are going to have to punch it to death here. Because I'm fairly certain if you try to magic it, it gets very angry.
Yeah, well, you know what? If he magics me, I get very angry.
Oh, but then again, that might still be reflectable. So, I guess cast Reflect first and then see what happens.
It's been a bit since you played. We're in World 3. We're doing random side quests before we go into the final dungeon.
Yeah, we're basically at the end at this point.
Here we go. We're fighting Bahamut here.
Classic Final Fantasy shit right here.
I just got
fighting Bahamut for the badass summons.
Yeah, I just got my last class, the Mime, like a little bit ago. Yeah, we are preparing to go into the void, so just finishing up summoner stuff. Yeah, how about we?
Yeah, we got this and then Phoenix Tower. Cast Carbuncle. Have someone summon Syldra, just to see what happens. I mean, if you die, you die, but at least you'll know, because it'd be beneficial if you could get it to reflect things right now.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Get wrecked, idiot.
Oh, God, yeah, this is kind of unfair. Oh, he didn't counterattack that one. Interesting. Golem is probably a decent choice. Or not.
I still have Reflect up.
Do you? Oh, can you see it when you're in the summon screen?
Only when I'm in the summon screen.
Yeah, alright, I see. Alright, that's nice. Also, wow, get wrecked by fucking Whirlwind. Do you have Golem up? Because I would sincerely recommend it.
Yes, probably a good plan.
Since he will basically kill you in one hit, since most of your people do not have health.
He's going to kill me in one hit if I don't have Reflect, so... That's why I have to keep constantly checking to make sure I have it.
Yeah, fair.
You son of a bitch! It was like 0.1 second that I didn't have it. Like, my last action, I had it, and then between my action and his counterattack, it ran out. Oh my god.
Get destroyed, sir.
That is not fair. I wanna appeal that.
You want a do-over?
That, how, why? It's so unfair. I don't deserve this. I was so careful, and the game chose the one point where I couldn't interact in order to, like, make it run out.
All right, that's twice now Carbuncle has run out of an inopportune moment.
Yeah. Why can't we reflect like we can with the golem?
I mean, that is a absolutely fair question. I would love it if we could just refresh it. By the way, you should probably get golem up. Just for good measure. Safety and all that. Come on, counterattack. I mean, that works, I guess. It's worth noting that Ferris does not have an air knife equipped.
Yeah, I know.
Also, did you just put someone to cast Carbuncle and you're just gonna auto-battle it again?
Yeah, I am, actually.
Oh, wow, you can't even change Ferris's equipment. Yeah,
whatever. My strategy is for him to kill himself.
Fair. Hey, that one worked.
I don't know why he won't counterattack me now. It's like he knows. That's not great.
Oh.
Lena, what did you do? I know this is your fault somehow. I feel vulnerable here.
Entirely possible. Oh, geez. Well, not at this particular moment.
Idiot. Get dunked on.
He absolutely did that to himself. God, summoners just solve so many problems.
They really do. There's a reason it's like an A-tier class.
It's an S-tier class, sir. Not undersell summoner.
It's like high A's.
It's definitely S.
I only put things at S-tier that, like, can clear the super bosses by themselves, too.
That's kind of an unfair standard, because that only there's not many things that can do that, and some of the ones that can aren't even necessarily that good on their own. Like, Beastmaster falls in that category in the GBA games, but it's definitely not an S-tier class at all.
Like, my S-tier is, like, Chemist, Blue Mage, Time Mage. I can see an argument that Summoner should be in it, too.
Here's the thing, like, I think it, like, you gotta look at the game as a whole and not just the end of it. Because personally, having gone through it multiple times with both classes, it's easier to play through the game with Summoner than it is to play through with Time Mage until Meteor. Because there's a distinct period in, like, World 2 where Time Mage is just kind of garbage because the only damage they have is Comet, and Comet is not good damage for World 2. And then you get to the start of World 3, and it's like, you don't have anything you could do for damage. It's like, you have Haste and Haste Aga, and that's great, but you have to rely on Rods for damage at the start of World 3 until you get Meteor. Whereas at least Summoner just kind of is good throughout the entire game. I can definitely understand how, like, once they're both fully stacked up, Time Mage might be better than Summoner. Summoner does have the highest magic stat, though.
It does. It's really good. I think Summoner is, like, the fourth most powerful class, I'd say.
Yeah.
It's just a matter of whether number four goes in, like, the first slot in A tier or, like, the last slot in S tier. Okay, great. Oh, fuck, alright. Let's do Phoenix Tower and then we'll call it a day. And then that leaves our last stream for next week will be just doing the Void and any super bosses we care to try out. I think we'll kill Shinryu probably, but I don't now we have Golem, nope. So like Shinryu should be pretty easy to kill.
Yeah, pretty sure he'll be harder for me to kill than he will be for you to kill,
but I don't like it might be possible for my team to kill Omega, but it doesn't seem very likely. Oh, fuck.
Oh, get wrecked.
Well, we have a good plan for Shinryu. We have the Wonder Rod to berserk him, and then we also have the ability to use Golem to protect ourselves from him, so...
Yeah, I mean, if you just have... You may even legit need to just have someone spam Golem every turn, because he's actually strong enough to potentially strip Golem in a single attack.
Yeah.
And he's very fast, but... I mean, even if we're, you know, at the worst case scenario, that's not that big a deal, and you still have three people that can just spam attack him, and he can't damage you at all. Summoner and White Mage using Blink are, like, the two classes that can very easily just, you just berserk Shinryu, and then you prevent him from being able to hit you, and you're fine.
Yeah, I think, like... I could have the Dragoon hit hit Omega with the Trident, but or like Rama can deal a little damage to Omega, but I meant the Trident.
I don't think your party has the ability to survive him for that long.
Yeah, it doesn't seem like that's gonna work out well. So
you don't have any way to stop him from fighting back, and I just don't think you have the survivability here without like a lot of level grinding.
Probably not. Okay. We saved. Alright, I will be back in just a minute. Alright, stream. Why don't you talk to Yarok for a minute? There we go.
No, what? Why? Don't put me on the spot.
Tell him to spin a yarn for them. You're Yarok the storyteller.
Spin a yarn? Yeah. I am not Yarok the storyteller.
Yeah, I'll be right back.
Oh my goodness. Oh, let me think. Well, actually, you want a story. Here's a story, since we're on the topic of the super bosses. There was a period where Magicus had decided that he wanted to take on Omega, and he had Bard, and Bard has an ability, I forget which one it is, Romeo's Ballad, I think, which casts Stop on all enemies, and it works on Shinryu. So if you're fast enough and you have enough people using it, not Shinryu, it works on Omega. Well, it might work on Shinryu as well, but it works on Omega. And if you're, so if you're fast enough and you have enough people using it, you can keep Omega stopped permanently and he can't ever fight. And so for him, it required three of his characters just singing Romeo's Ballad over and over, but it was enough to prevent Omega from ever being able to do anything. And then for his fourth character, just because he could, he chose to unequip his weapons and punch Omega to death, because critical hits from unarmed attacks ignore defense and could do like 4 to 6 damage, I think. I think it, he told me it took him like several hours to do. It was very dumb, but he did it. There's a video on his channel somewhere you can find on his YouTube channel. I'll ask him to post a link when he comes back. But yeah, so if you've ever wanted to watch someone kill Omega with just punches and not from a monk, that is a thing that can be done. Oh yeah, no, Neo Shinryu and Omega Mark II. Those were in the GBA dungeon, if I recall correctly. Which I think was also in the mobile version. I never actually went through that dungeon. GBA and iOS, yeah.
Alright, here we are.
Oh, you're back?
I am back. So what kind of story did you regale everyone with?
I told them about you using 3 bards to punch Omega to death.
Oh yeah, that was a great time. I enjoyed that a lot.
I said you had a video of it. I said you should. I was going to tell you to like find a link or something if you can.
Yeah, I actually can put a link to that in the chat. Here we go. I think this should be the right one. This was definitely, I think I put it on, I definitely sped it up by a fair bit.
I think. How long was it? I couldn't remember.
I think completely unedited, it was like 40 some minutes.
Jeez.
And that was with using rapid fire.
I guess that's not as short as I thought, or as long as I thought. I thought it was like so few hours.
Well,
I did mention you had rapid fire.
Yeah, without rapid fire, it takes hours. So I got to cut down. I edited the time to be really short, and like, I'm using auto battle with rapid fire, and I sped it up in the editor to get it to a manageable amount. But like, yeah, it was like 40 actual minutes or so. And if you don't have rapid fire and you're not using an editor to speed it up, like in the footage, it's gonna be hours. But it will work. Alright, so there's one thing we need to know.
Are you looking up the route?
I am definitely looking up the route here.
Avoiding the fight. This guy.
Okay. Look, it is a long ass fucking walk up these stairs, okay? Oops. And this is actually an area where I probably do not want to be auto running. Okay. Yeah, the enemies are kind of difficult to run from.
As a, if I recall correctly, you can't run from them. You actually have to kill them every time.
We are left side. Uh-oh. Damn it!
Oh, get destroyed.
Great job surviving another day at work. All the little victories should be celebrated. Okay.
There's no thing here. Just go up the stairs. Or, oh, are you going to mess with them?
Yes. I have enough elixirs. I should be able to do it.
I didn't realize you needed the AP.
Well, I may as well, because I'm trying to master these classes.
Well, careful there, buddy.
Yeah. Only one, that's great.
Wow, that was lucky.
See, now they can trade off in classes. Yeah, Krill can go back to trying to master Summoner. And you can work on Dragoon. Now you get to be Kane!
That is very, very close to Kane's look.
There's only a few pixels difference. There we go. This is a very good opportunity to master all these classes. Okay. Left side. And left side. No. Damn it!
Get wrecked.
It's just a dick move.
Kinda. I mean, it could work on one of them.
Oh my god, okay. So if I have to keep fighting these things, I might not actually have enough, I may not have enough fucking Phoenix Downs for this. Oh, I already used it. Yeah, high potion. On the plus side, it means Phoenix will be useful coming back down the stairs.
Yeah, right?
Just one more thing the summoners can accomplish to save us money. Alright. Right side. This side is money. Oh, fuck.
Well, at least it doesn't have one of those.
Yeah. Grab our cash. And, alright, here we go. Give me elixir. Okay. Sweet!
Wow, alright. It's being very generous today.
Think? Okay, Lena has mastered Monk. So I guess I can just switch Lena and Ferris.
Yeah, Lena could be your permanent mime then. She should have better HP that way now, because I'm pretty sure that works like that. Yep. Yeah, she's got 1,400 now.
Nope, not that. here, Hermes sandals. Yeah, alright.
Was Lena equipped properly?
Nope. You can pretty much always count on the fact that they're never going to be equipped properly. Alright.
There you go.
Alright. Okay, this 11th floor. Yeah, nothing. We just
this
go
one up. Doesn't have a thing.
Nope. I'm just trying to make sure I don't get lost in what floor we're on. This one.
We're on 12.
Can I just use Mimic? Yeah.
Oh yeah, I guess you can.
I think it saves me MP if I do that.
Yeah, it shouldn't cost any.
Alright. We're halfway up. Alright. Again, we want to go to this side. And it switches. More money and another one of these magic pots. Oops. Can we get it on one more time? You're gonna Lamia's harp from that.
Yeah, something.
You should actually have the air knife on for this. Yeah, okay. Also, you should have the air knife on too.
Herp, herp, derp.
Alright. Can we get it on one? Alright. Sick!
Wow.
We might get all of them.
The RNG is in your favor. RNGesus blesses this run.
Alright. Alright, yeah, we just go up here. It should be left side. Then left again. That was not pleasant. Starting to run out of MP.
That's what ethers are for.
Yep. Alright.
Pretty sure you bought ethers for this purpose. And never used them until now. So yeah. It's about time they started to come in handy.
I figured they would eventually. Okay, here we go. I got a reflect ring from that.
Oh, yeah, I saw that.
Alright. Can we do four in a row? Come on. Be awesome. Yes!
Wow.
We're actually going for the 5-0. Where's Contra?
Holy shit. All right, so hold on. What is that now? That's,
four in 50, a row.
81. So it's a 1 in 3 chance that that happens each time. You've done it 4. That's a 1 in 81 chance.
Is there even another one? Because the last floor is just... No, there is one more. So, yeah, we could... We are actually going for the 5-0.
Yeah, there's you've already accomplished what would be a 1 out of 81 chance.
Two reflect rings off of that! What the fuck?
Speaking of ridiculous chances, now you've got 4 reflect rings.
I have 5 reflect rings! 5 reflect rings. Oh, shit.
Did you even get the money on the other side? I don't even think you got the money on the other side.
No, I did. I got the 20 grand.
Okay. 22.
I'm so nervous. I have to see if we get this now. This will make going through Phoenix Tower worth it on its own. This is on the left. This is the right, and then we go for the 5-0. Okay, it's the moment of truth. Chat, do you think we can do it? Can we do it? Yes! We did it! We did it! The 5-0!
So, 1 in 243.
That is absolutely ridiculous. Okay. Okay, alright, now we just gotta go and get our Phoenix.
Wow. Just wow.
I have no words.
yeah. No, oh, you're out of mana again. And you also
no,
elixirs.
No, don't do that. Fuck. If you're gonna use elixirs, use them on someone who needs them.
I'm at least slightly content that it cost you slightly more elixirs because you were not paying attention.
Whatever. It doesn't matter. We got the 5-0. That's all that matters. Yeah, I don't think that's ever going to happen to me again playing this game.
Probably not.
Seems incredibly unlikely.
You might want to use a few more ethers before you take on the next door.
Yeah, I know. We actually have a boss fight we can't avoid.
Yeah.
Oh, Ferris has mastered Monk now. Okay. Well, Krill is almost done with Summoner, I think. Or level 5, right? Yeah, that should be the last one. So, once Krill's done, I'll switch those two. Yeah, okay, we should be fine. Oh, it's the Soul Cannon. It just looks like a dildo on a wall.
Yeah, it actually does not look very proper at all here right now. I'm not sure if that's the thing you have to fight or if it's also random.
I think it is random.
I don't remember. Yeah, I think there is another option you could have had.
There we go. Oh, look, it's the Windrake.
Specifically, it's Lena's Windrake.
Yep.
Because this game actually does have two different Windrakes.
Yep. They're both named, but I forget what the other one's actually named.
No, they never. Krill's Windrake never is never given a name. It's
Beast?
just the
Really?
Windrake.
I thought it
Yeah.
had a name.
No, they never actually mention a name for it. I mean, I'm sure it has a name, but they never actually refer to it as anything. Also, what a boss, man. He died for our sins more than once.
That's true. That is actually pretty impressive.
Of course, our penance is that we have to walk back out.
Yeah, unfortunately, because we can't just like teleport out of this place.
Not without the actual teleport spell, which you can't use.
Nope.
I forget which class actually gets that.
Think Time Mage?
Is it me? Because that'd be great. I would love to have teleport.
I'm pretty sure it's you. You're the one that gets it.
It's either me or it's a white mage. I don't recall if which one it is though.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, it is a time magic spell. Nice. Time magic for the win.
Now we can summon Phoenix and save ourselves 1,000 gil on Phoenix Downs.
It also is equivalent to like fire too.
Woo.
Yeah.
Now we get to do the long walk outside. Yay. We may as well go get like a bunch more weapons because we have like two tablets still. And go visit the sealed castle again.
Yeah, one last time. I take it we're just skipping the trench.
Yeah, I don't think I need the trench knowing that I can't use most of that shit, so.
Yeah. Well, you've done enough optional content.
Yeah. There's not really anything that I particularly need from there, so.
The best thing it offers at this point is the ability to level grind using the thingy, which you
But
don't even need because you can just level grind anyway. You are the summoner.
yeah.
Magic lamp. That's I lost the word there.
Yep. I mean, and this is pretty effective, so. And you can do this in the desert, and it's still just as great. But I don't think I need to be level grinding here at this point, anyway.
Probably not.
I just need Kotoblepas to get lucky and actually work.
Yeah.
Which higher levels do help with, I believe, but not like significantly. I'd have to get a lot more levels to make it matter. The plus side is the Aegis Shield means I might have more than one try to like do it. Because I can always Phoenix everyone back up alive and then go from there once I succeed.
As long as one of them lives, yeah.
So Phoenix is actually really useful for that final fight for that reason. Soldier's got to be getting tired by now.
Soldier's a ghost. Ghosts don't get tired.
Though I think getting tired is one reason you might become a ghost, like if someone runs over you with their car.
Oh, your mana's running out. And you're a frog.
Maybe I wanted to be a frog. Did you ever think about that?
No, I didn't. Did you just get another reflect ring?
I got a Lamia's harp from that one.
Oh, okay.
That's okay.
That's all she wrote.
We'll be fine. Look how fine we are.
Only 14 more floors to go.
I said we'll be fine. Why don't you believe me?
Lena is one ability point away from, or not Lena, whoever it is one ability point away, Krill, from mastering her thing.
Uh-oh.
Oh, that's bad.
I don't actually know if I even have any holy waters.
Did you really not bother to buy any?
Oh, I have a couple, okay.
I would have laughed very hard if you got murdered because of that. Well, I like how they're just coming out in force with the status effects now.
They know I'm beaten down and this is hurting.
You're worn out, you're weak.
Okay.
Wait. I don't think you can change her job while she's dead.
I think I can, actually.
Okay, apparently you can.
Yeah, I guess so. I think I'm gonna have to use an elixir.
Just one?
Yep. Go. 11 floors, that's nothing. We got this. God damn it. Can we just, like, not for 1 minute?
Well, I don't... Clearly you haven't realized that that's a counterattack and you're triggering it yourself.
Not anymore. Krill is just not participating in fights now.
I mean, fair.
It kicked me right in the Moivenhoiven. So close, we're almost free. Oh, I got Hermes sandals from that one.
Oh, yeah, I saw that.
I can buy some elixirs back now.
You're gonna need to after this.
Yeah, I really am.
Pretty sure that's her last soldier.
It is, yep. All right, we're getting to the final stretch here. I think we're gonna make it. By the time I get to X-Death, I might actually be able to survive, like, a fucking Almagest.
It's entirely possible. If you threw, like, HP plus 30% on, you'd have quite a bit of health.
Alright,
well, we made it out. That's step one. Now, can we get back to the Chocobo?
What are we doing on classes here? Alright, Bartz is like getting close on Dragoon. To navigate through the mountains here. Alright. So tired. Take my 10 gil, please. All right. think. I think we could sell a few of these extra rings we picked up.
Yeah, probably.
I don't even need reflect rings at this point, but I'm happy to just have four of them, I guess.
It's not a bad thing to have extras of. Or to have on hand.
Yeah.
Protect rings are pretty useless, though.
Wait, do I only have two of these?
You only bought two. Like, you had one, and you bought one more.
I really... Okay, then I do need to buy one more of those.
Yeah, I said that the last time you were here, but you were like, nah, I'm good. I'll get it before I go in.
I just grossly miscounted, I guess.
How do you miscount three from four?
Because I thought I got another one, but I guess no. I think it was because I got a reflect ring as a drop and not the coral ring. Alright. Isn't this, like, a rare drop that, like, can only... Yeah... You can only get as if this is a drop, right?
I'm not sure. Maybe? I feel like you got... I think you got it in a chest.
Oh, you know what? I might have.
Because you definitely got a bow in a chest in the water area. And I think that's the only bow you have.
What do I feel like parting with? Diamond armlet don't seem useful. I mean, I could sell, like...
The swords. You could sell the swords.
I could. I'm always sad to sell that stuff.
I mean, you can't use them anyway. And the Gaia hammer. The death sickle. Rising Sun.
I mean, I can't.
The Beast Killer.
I could use it, but I don't actually intend to, so.
Yeah.
I'm not selling the ribbon. I refuse.
Fair, I guess.
I can buy one more elixir and maybe some ethers because I'm completely out of those and I'm probably going to need a lot.
That's all she wrote.
Yeah, I guess let's hope that's enough. I think we'll be
fine.
It'll
just have to be.
We're gonna be okay. Look how fine we are. See, I think that's everything I care about here.
Yeah, we didn't do the trench, but we don't care. And I think you did everything else.
Alright. And this is a good spot to leave it.
Right. Yep, we're ready for the void on our last run.
I'm at 13 hours here.
Alright, and you are ready to go into the void.
Yep.
I need to see how much I can catch up to that.
We'll have to see. So then next week we are definitely finishing this game. We're like the very home stretch now. All of the side nonsense is finished, so we're gonna go for it. Everybody,
triumph or die.
Yeah, everybody who's watching, I appreciate you guys being here with me. Like I said, next week we should be finishing this on Monday, as long as you're free.
Yep, I probably will be.
Yeah, so that's all I've got for now. I appreciate you all being here. If you're gonna watch my replay, my camera died.
Yeah, so you seem to have frozen.
You know, I cannot like let this. Okay, no, I have to fix this. I'm not ending my stream with the camera dead. Fuck that. All right, we're gonna do this right. Okay. There we go. It's better. Okay. All right. We're here. So yeah, if you're watching the replay of this, please click the thumbs up button. I always really appreciate that. We got to click the thumbs up because we got the 5-0 in here. So
yeah, so if nothing else, that 5-0 on the magic pots is worth it.
Yeah, and yeah, this will take us like really close to the banned and restricted announcement for actually all the formats in Magic, because that is coming up on the 7th, which we will be playing the 31st. So yeah, the 7th will be the week following that, and I will certainly have a video. No matter what happens, I'm sure I will have something to say on the matter. So definitely expect a video related to Magic the week following. So yeah, but that's it. That's all I'm doing for today. So everyone, I love you all. You're the best around. No one's ever going to take you down. And I'll see you next time. Later, everyone.
Yep. Peace out, everybody.